Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we are going to see how to do quantization with the Llama CPP and how to convert a transformer model into the GGUF format, meaning that we are going to do a kind of quantization, and not only that, also be able to use the Llama CPP library, which means that we are going to run at least our inference or our fine-tuning in a library, which is essentially written down in C++, and it's meaning that obviously is running very, very fast in comparison with Python. Okay, I have prepared a small script and a documentation of how we can do that. And also a README. Let me start from the beginning. And just, oops, this is not 1 second. Okay, so one time, 1 second. Exactly. So first of all, we are going to configure the environment to you be able to do the quantization, to take a model from the Huey phase and convert it to GGUF format with the data type that you want to transform it. To start with, let me show you what we have in the original Llama. I installed the latest version of the Llama CPP, and then there is some models that are the ones that are already supported. This is on this. You go to the Llama CPP repository. You go to the script, to the Python script convert HF. So hyper HF hyper to hyper GUF hyper update.py. You have a number of models that you can directly transform just using the script. The process is not 100% correctly documented, but it's really okay. You can easily understand what is the problem in case that you have one. So as you can see here, I'm gonna use today a model Microsoft Phi Mini. In this case, with 128 is not on the list. I will show you how you can introduce your new model. And essentially, if you want to introduce another model, not here, the first thing that you need to do is introduce it on this list. Remember the path. And here, and then I'll follow what the steps I will show you on the video. So first or second, download the model that you want to convert to GGUF. In this case, I'm downloading the Phi 3 Mini 128, which is not on the list, and then I download it with the I create this small Python script with using a snapshot underscore download from Hugging Face Hub library. You download the model, the original model with the tensors. Let me show you into this library with the safe tensors into this library P3 Hyper 128. Okay, once you have it, choose whatever you want, take a look what you have in the list. You go like in my case to this file and include a section similar to this. So there is this is just to understand the type of tokenizer that your model has in order to do correctly the conversion. So according to the documentation, we have three types of tokenizers: SPM, BPM, and WPM. In the case, like it was in my case, is pretty simple because the model is of the same series, so it has the same tokenizer. It's not really documentation to understand if your tokenizer is similar to one of the others that are already included, SPM, BPM, or WPM. If you have any other issues, the Gergenov, the the writer, o sea, the person who create Gerganov, sorry, the person who create Llama CPP asks you to create a ticket, and they can help us to solve the issue. But you will see that at least for I don't think that well, you have here plenty of models. I will show you here all of them. The one you have here is not similar to what you have. You have Falcon, Llama 2, Llama 3, Phi, DSeek, Falcon, VGA, MPT, Starcoder, GPT-2, Zephyr, Rifat, Queen, Olmo, Gina, Smaug, Poro, Odegina, and Viking. So it is something really different to one of the ones that you have here, something that I really doubt. But contact Gerganov or create a ticket, and then he will help you to solve it. It's not well, maybe you even can contact me. I can again try to help you. I'm not a specialist, but I think I will be able to help you as well. In any case, so in my case, just to create a GUI for this document, for this file, I just create an entry here in the original update, and that's it. Now, after modifying this, the next step after downloading the model is clone the Gerganov, the Llama CPP repo, install the requirements TST, and case that you have and run this script, convert HF to GGUID update with your token. This is the Hugging Face token. Either you have it in memory or you can pass it in the command line. If this gives you an issue, like it was in my case, I'm running a this in Windows 3.11 with a Python 3.11 in with a Python 3.11 environment, and then I got an issue with Torch, and then to solve it I just installed Torch with my correct CUDA version, because here on the requirements TXT let me show you, there is not really clear which Torch is, just installing Torch is not requiring any CUDA version, and then case that you had a problem, again I solve it away, just install Torch, not necessarily you need Torch Vision or Torch Audio, with your pointing to the correct version of your CUDA toolkit. Once you had this done, this script update token, it will download all the tokenizers into the folder model, all the tokenizers of that are in this model list. Okay, and it will do some tests of these tokenizers with this string. It will tokenize this string and do some checks to verify that everything is okay, even with the new that you did. It is not okay, it will raise an exception. For example, if the tokenizer type is not correct, in any case, I don't think it's going to raise anything, because this is not doing practically anything. It's just creating an enumeration, but okay, it's fine. It is raise something, again, something I doubt. How to say, we will need to change the type of the tokenizer. In case there is an issue that you cannot move forward, let me know, or write a bug in, or lock a bug in the repository. Okay, once you have all the tokenizers in models, you need to create the GGUS file for your tokenizer. As you can see here in the instruction I write down here, is you call the same script. You just point out to the tokenizer that you want to convert. In this case, I will convert the model's tokenizer fee 328, the model I had downloaded, and you provide a name for that file. It has to be a GGUS file, and it has to be on the folder models and or with the parameter vocab only. This is going to include any special character in the tokenizer vocabulary to later on have everything that the conversion need to do correctly the conversion. And once you have that, you just run the conversion. So we are going to run the command to convert the vocabulary, just to show you. So I will run convert my, so I see that the tokenizer is the P328. You take a look here. So the name was P328, and here we had in model the tokenizer that the original script download. Now we just run the script, and you can see it's doing some tests and writing a file. Here is, you can see here, this file, GGML vocab. That one exactly vocab P300GUF. Okay, once you have that done, we run the conversion of the model, and then the conversion of the model, you just run a help to see the options we have, and minimally or at least we need the model. This is the folder where you had the model that you recently downloaded. In my case, it's P3Hyper128, and also the out file. This is the name of the file that you will use, and the out type. So I already have a floating point 16 and QA 0, and now we are going to create a brain float 16. You have here the types that you can convert. You can see here that we have as well floating points 32. And you may answer, well, Juan, why this? Because it's the same format that that you had in the original model. Yeah, it's true, but if you convert this to GGUS format, you are going to use the C library, the Llama CPP library. And it's a C++ library which is running extremely faster in comparison with the Python one. So if you just simply convert with the same weights, don't touch in the weights, just convert the layers that can be converted into GGUS format, you will be able to use Llama CPP, which is at least three times or four times faster than the Python library. So here I'm going to convert to floating point 16, and later on the notebook we will see the quantized 8-bit Q8 is integer 8, which is four times smaller. That is also not true, because you probably know that you don't transform all the layers, so normalization layers cannot be converted to other data type, because you cannot lose precision on the normalization layers, because you usually work with the normalized data there. You cannot do normalization. We will see this later on. So now we just transform. Here is brainflow 16. We are going to convert now to F16. And then on the name, we will give, for example, existing. Yes, that's it. So here, Python llama .cpp slash convert hyper hf hyper 2 hyper guf dot py. The folder where you had the original model, hyper hyper out file, the name of the output file, and hyper hyper output out type, in this case floating 16. Let's check auto. I will check it later. So we start the conversion, and it takes 2-3 minutes. So now you see here, so this is all the layers that we had in our feed, and you see that some of the layers are converting. Yeah, float to float 16, float 32. So you can see here, yeah, well, most of the layers are already in float 16, so that's why the size in many cases, yeah, it's really silly to convert it to flat in 32 in this case. But you will see here that you can do this with the feed forwarding layers, with the attention layers, but you can do anything with the normalization layers. Okay. Now it's converting, writing the file. It's gonna take some seconds, and later we will try on the notebook. Okay, this is done. You see here we have the floating point 16, and if you check the files, yeah, this conversion probably is not the optimal one. The most optimal is the Q80. Well, try at your in your environment with different options and auto as well, and check which layers are converted, which not, your sites, and later, as you will see here, I prepare an output. I will post it as well later on to the repository, and you can do the test as well. So here I just upload the model to my the first one I transformed with Q8 integer 8 bits, and here we just install the Python the Llama CPP with GPU support. Don't forget that, because need to be this on memory to install correctly. It's not, it will not get access to the GPU. Here, just clean the GPU, and then you can now load the GUID file using Llama. Sorry, Llama CPP. You just point to the path of the file, and the name of the context window, the number of tokens that you are going to use, number of threads in CPU, number of layers in total that you are going to move to the GPU. Which layers you need to move to the GPU? Well, this is you need to count them this is really something really difficult to answer, no? How many? So or an easy answer would be, move everything that you have in your model. Why? Because if you don't move all the layers to the GPU, which is possible, you will have a transit in between GPU and the CPU. And then the advantage that you have of having the execution in software that is compiled in C++, you lose it because of the penalty of moving data between CPU and GPU. So if you have memory, move everything to the GPU. My advice, since it's not worth it to do this change, no? So this is an output I just adapted from a previous one I used a couple of days ago for another video, with I work with the FI 128 key, transforming this or loading into MLflow in original format or ONNX, and also in, I download the version from quantized version from Hugging Face. But this is the one I use. I put it on my homemade the file, this one, and this is the one I load. And you can check here that we had a model with QA. This is in 8 byte, sorry. And this is kind of 3 gigabytes. You look at my GPU, it's at L4, 24 gigas. But I only spending 5.1. I'm doing the same test that I did before with some two texts. I'm doing a binary classifier, CV, non-CV. I prepare a prompt and I send the prompt to the model and I calculate the time. So here, just I send the LLM, just look at this one second. This is really fast. And then again, if you had a GPU, do it like this, because this is really extremely fast. And then on, okay, correct. It's answering what I am asking. And there I do the other text. And essentially 2 seconds, yeah, extremely fast in comparison, yeah, non-CV as well. And finally, if you want to load the model to the Hugging Face, to your account, just use this cell, and you can share the model with the rest of the community. You make the job, but well, others can take advantage of this job. If you go to Hugging Face and take this model, this is the one I use in this video. You can download it, you can use it, and you test it. And well, if you find it something that is not working or correctly, let me know in the comments of the video. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you enjoy, you find it interesting and useful for your training, your job, or whatever reason you are watching this video. And if that's the case, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and share with your friends and colleagues, just to help me to promote the channel in YouTube. Thank you very much. See you soon.